Hello everyone, welcome to Tech Times. In today's video, I'm gonna show you what is the difference between Vlookup and Hlookup in Microsoft Excel. The main difference between the two functions is in the direction of the search. The Vlookup function searches for a value vertically down a column and returns a value from the same row in a specified column to the right. On the other hand, the Hlookup function searches for a value horizontally across a row and returns a value from the same column in a specified row below. Let me illustrate it with an example. Suppose we have to calculate the number of marks obtained by Nasir Qureshi in chemistry subject. What Vlookup function would do, it would first go to find out the name of Nasir Qureshi vertically down. When it has spotted the name, then it would go horizontally to spot his chemistry score. And in case of Hlookup function, let's suppose we have to find out the chemistry score of Asif Najm. Excel would search the name horizontally after spotting the name Asif Najm. Then it would go down in the same column to spot the chemistry score of Asif Najm. Let's see how we can use these two functions in Microsoft Excel. Suppose you have been given a data like this and it is spread across thousands of rows and hundreds of columns, then trying to find a specific value in a large data set is too difficult. This is where comes Vlookup function. Suppose in this particular data set we are going to calculate the chemistry score of John Alam. What we would do, we will write is equal Vlookup, and you can see we have four arguments over here. First one is lookup value. So this name is going to be our lookup value, and after that we will have to press comma, table array. Let's choose the table array, comma, and let's find out column index. Since we have to spot chemistry score of Johnny Alam, we will have to give column index number over here as well. So the column in which chemistry scores are written is at fifth number. You can count right from here, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So we'll write 5, again comma. Now you can see we have been given two options. For true, for approximate match, we will enter true, and for exact match, we will enter false. For true, you can enter 1, for false, you can enter 0 as well. Let me click on false, as we have to find out the exact match. Now close the bracket and press enter, and there you go. You can see we have located the chemistry score of John Alam. Now you can change the name and find out the chemistry score of any other student. Let me show you. Let me change the name to Umesh Kumar. Enter, and there you go. You can see here is the score. Let me press Ctrl Z to go back. Similarly, over here we can calculate the score of any student using Hlookup function. Again is equal Hlookup. Again, you can see we have four arguments. First one is lookup value. This is going to be our lookup value. Table array, we will have to choose this table array, comma, and the third argument is row index number. In Vlookup function, it was over here column index number, but in case of Hlookup function, we have row index number. So the row index number for chemistry is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So we'll enter 6 over here, again comma, and this time again for the exact match, we'll put 0 or false, close the bracket, enter, and there you go. You can see this is chemistry and this is John Alam. This is his score. I hope you have found this tutorial useful. Please leave a like, subscribe, and thanks for watching.